Hello everyone, my name is Moses Len Jau and welcome to another episode of the ASEAN Project. Today's episode will be another special episode, and that episode will be Understanding Borneo, Gawai and also Kaamatan Edition. Before we go further into today's video, our video today is sponsored by one of the best beer in the world, and that is Heineken. So don't forget to check out Heineken and also try Heineken, because who doesn't love Heineken, right? I love Heineken. Okay, love Heineken.
I love Heineken.
First guest for today is...
My name is Hero Jambo, anak undit. Come from Riaman, known as Simangga.
Bangsa apa lah?
Bangsa saya bangsa Iban.
Sudah sedia untuk gawai nggak belum?
Belum.
So the next guest for today is from a place called the Land Below the Wind. That is from Sabah. Introduce yourself.
I'm Angie from Papar, Sabah, and I'm Kadazan.
Kadazan. Quick question lah, what's the difference between Kadazan and also Dusun?
The area, which is the district, and then the language is actually a bit different, and the outfit also.
Alright, so now we go to the third guest for today, and he is from a place called the Land of the Hornbill.
Hi, my name is Elvin Spencer. Normally call me Bobon.
Ah, Bobon. Bobon. Okay.
I'm Bidayo, I'm from Bau.
Apa yang best di Bau?
Yang best di Bau. Ya, Serikin lah. Makan kolok mie. Kolok mie Bau best.
If you have a choice lah, between Laksa, Laksa Sarawak, kolok mie, and also Panso. Which one would you choose lah? If a gun is pointed at your head.
Okay lah, Panso lah.
Panso. Panso.
I would choose Laksa.
Laksa?
Laksa for life.
Macam tu saya pilih kolok lah.
Makanan yang tinggal lah.
So now let's go to the first question. What is Gawai and also Kaamatan? Japo, what is Gawai?
Okay, dalam Iban yang paling famous tiga Gawai.
Tiga Gawai.
Yang gawai yang ada di kami adalah gawai burung, gawai Dayak dengan gawai hantu. So yang kami akan sambut pada bulan 6 ni adalah gawai Dayak. Kalau gawai Dayak ni dia untuk Thanksgiving kepada Dewa Padi.
Let's say kalau gawai burung?
Kalau gawai burung, mau kepada untuk tengok mimpi, mentafsir mimpi.
Kalau gawai hantu?
Okay, kalau gawai hantu dia kepada memberi makanan kepada roh-roh yang sudah mati.
Okay lah, so let's go from a Bidayuh point of view lah. How do Bidayuh usually celebrate Gawai lah?
Normally Bidayuh satu Gawai lah, normally celebrate
Gawai Dayak,
Gawai Dayak lah. Bidayuh akan panggil Gawai Sowak lah, Gawai Sowak. Dia punya celebration sama lah, untuk give appreciation to Semangat Padi lah, Selamat Menuai lah.
Let's go to the other side of Borneo, which is Sabah lah. So like in Sabah, for example the Kadazan and the Dusun right, they celebrate Kaamatan kan. So what is Kaamatan?
Kaamatan tu not celebrated only by Kadazan Dusun. We call it KDMR lah. Kadazan Dusun, Murut, Rungos. The biggest four lah, major four lah.
Kira the four tribes lah.
We all share the same history lah. Untuk mengenangkan pengorbanan Hominodun, iaitu perempuan yang cantik dikorbankan oleh ayahnya sendiri untuk menaikkan semangat padi. So ada Sabah ni penuh dengan padi-padi untuk makan. Diorang buat pertandingan perempuan paling cantik, selected Hominodun. So the dads have to sacrifice her, ambil darah tu, tabur dekat tanah-tanah semua.
Sedih boleh
cakap? Ya, actually lah. But nowadays we just do the pageant like annually because itu macam sudah janji dengan Bobo Hizan. Kami tidak sacrifice, we do symbolic potong kerbau. Tapi the pageant mesti ada.
So what's the pageant called?
Unduk Ngadau.
Unduk Ngadau. Okay lah, Sanji. So what do you like about Kaamatan?
Kaamatan and Gawai is different lah. Dia ada dia punya satu syarat lah. So yang paling penting mesti ada Unduk Ngadau. And second penting tu Sugandoi. Sugandoi tu nyanyi pertandingan. Sebab tu orang Sabah suka nyanyi.
Macam if you perasan
okay.
Orang yang pandai menyanyi semua dari Sabah.
Macam
Moses. Ah, Moses. Inji. Kamu ada cover di YouTube kah?
Tidak.
Moses ada cover.
Suka dia.
Saja promote diri.
Kamu pernah ikut Sugandoi kah?
Pernah.
Kamu pernah?
Champion.
Champion lah.
Time
check. Oh, you pernah menang lah.
Boleh lah, kampung-kampung.
You won in kampung division lah.
Sudah.
Okay, okay. If I'm not mistaken, kamu pernah ikut Unduk Ngadau juga kan last year. So how was the experience lah joining Unduk Ngadau?
Unduk Ngadau is actually very challenging lah. Time consuming, cost consuming.
Oh really?
And you have to learn a lot about the culture.
Kenapa? What do you like about Gawai?
Kalau Gawai saya paling suka dia punya kasam babi.
Kasam babi? Apa kasam babi? Kepada orang yang tidak tahu lah.
kasar babi adalah macam preserved meat, pork meat.
Mentah kan?
Try ke?
Mentah. Macam kalau siapa, bosau.
Oh iya. Cara tadi?
Bosau.
Bosau.
Bahasa goreng ke? Dibuat sup ke?
Sup kering-kering.
Sup pekat-pekat.
Pekat-pekat.
That's the word. For you lah, in bau lah when you celebrate gawai. Apa-apa yang paling best celebration gawai bau?
Kalau dia pekasan babi, saya pansel babi.
Ini panso. So memang panso all the way lah.
Ya panso all the way lah.
Excel lah. Panso babi, panso ikan, panso ayam.
Babi lah dia.
Now, let's go to the next part of today's episode and that is the common tradition during gawai and also kamatan. Japok.
Yeah.
So what are the common tradition during gawai lah?
Jadi kalau kami ban belum malam 1 hari bulan tu, maksudnya 31 hari bulan kami akan prepare makanan, menghiasi ranyai. Ranyai itu macam tree of life. So akan letak makanan, hadiah-hadiah. Lepas tu pada malam 31 kami akan buat mirup air pengayung. Tu air pengayung.
Ni aku nemu.
Nak nemu. Nak nemu. Nak nemu.
Kau sebab nak ibarat.
Yeah.
I know how to ngabangun ni.
Mirup air pengayung mean toast.
Cheers.
Pada satu hari bulan tu pagi tu tua kampung dia akan buat piring. So kita sediakan 7 piring. Maksud 7 piring tu adalah makanan tu akan dipersembahkan kepada dewa padi. So akan guna ayam tabung yang terbaik. Ayam tu akan disembelih. So dia punya bulu tepak dia akan dipu dengan darah tu akan diletak di tiap piring. Lepas semua tu okey baru boleh start program. Macam program pertandingan kumang, keling, kantun.
Kan there's this one part of during gawai. Kan ranyai di kantong macam keropok. Kan ni kan pun ada orang kantong kan?
Ada tin punya.
Tin lah, okey lah.
Bukan botol.
Ranyai the pokok is pokok pisang kan?
Mula pokok nipah. Ha?
Tak kisah lah.
Tak kisah je ini dah.
So yang 7 miring tu kan, kan setelah disapu dengan darah.
Apa dalam dia? So, apa yang di dalam 7 piring tu adalah satu dia ada tirih dengan pinang, daun rokok dengan tembakau. Lepas tu ada belut, tumpik, lemang. Lepas tu ada telur ayam. Pansu tidak.
Tapi habis pansu.
Last kali tua.
So now we have listened from the Ivan point of view. Now let's go to the Kadazan point of view. So what are the common tradition during kamatan?
We also have the menyembah padi part lah. Tapi not so many people attend lah. Usually Bobo Hiza and a few people yang still trust lah. Sometimes we do the symbolic macam acting for it. If we really join the Bobo Hiza part, memang I remember like the part hujung tu the miracle happen as in dalam satu bekas tu tiba-tiba ada padi hujung dia. Before kosong, menyembah at the end ada padi. Kami orang tiada ngabang. So memang every dari kampung and then peringkat daerah sampai state level dekat KDCA akan kumpul untuk tengok Dung Ngadau, Sugandoi and sukan-sukan tradisi yang harus dikekalkan. As in tarik tali, plastik tu.
Plastik tu.
Habak Hamon, which is lawan tangan lah. Siapa paling
berat tengah?
Berat tengah.
Wrestling.
Gesti lengan.
Aduh.
Lengan.
Kurang apa ya? Harus. Harus. Okay, so now we go to the next part of the video. I'm gonna say a word in Bahasa Malaysia or in English, and then they are gonna translate it into their native language. So we go first to Bobon, representing the Bidayuh. That word is makan ataupun eat.
Makan Bidayuh akan sebut maan in Bidayuh. Maan is serian lah, Bidayuh serian.
If in Kayan, it's almost similar. In Kayan, makan is kuman.
Kuman.
Intinya keman. Okay, keman. More or less the keman. Same. If in Melanau, keman juga. Ini mana kah?
Makai.
Now we ask the Kadazan. The word is minum.
Kano moginum toko. Maksud dia, mari kita minum.
Okay, kalau mari kita minum Heineken.
Kano moginum Heineken.
Kano moginum Heineken.
Yeah.
Moginum is the word lah.
If for example minum air biasa, aku moginum lah.
Actually moginum maksud dia minum. Tapi dia sudah menjadi terlalu common. Moginum tu adalah minum arak lah.
Kalau orang kata macam ni, haus. Japo, I know you famous for this. I know it's kidding. What is mabok in Iban?
Iban apa? Palau.
Palau. Di Palau?
Tino.
Apa does it mean?
Lepas mabok, tidur.
Jangan mabok, kacau orang.
Yeah.
Jangan mabok,
drugi.
Now, the next part of the video below is they are going to say one word in their native language. The rest of us will try to guess the meaning of the word. So first, we go straight to the most handsome, Harold Jacob.
Cuba teka maksud gayu.
Besar.
Kan?
Jap. Okay. Okay,
ayat dah. Gayu guru gerai nyamai.
For this kind like me right, I always listen orang kata, oh selamat hari kawan, kayu guru gerai nyamai. Kita tahu pun maksud dia.
Ya.
Kayu
guru gerai bukan tu kah?
Kedai
makan.
Itu kedai makan.
Ada clue lah.
Tidak ada clue.
Jekul.
Jadi saya kalah.
Kalah saya akun saja lah.
Asik.
Kamalah. Kayu maksudnya panjang umur.
Oh. Kau gayu guru gerai nyamai tu?
Maksudnya panjang umur, berarti sehat sejahtera.
Oh.
Bagus lah, it's a prayer.
Baru saya tahu maksudnya. Okay, now we go to Kadaza. What's the word in Kadaza?
Pinohigut.
Pinohigut.
Kamu orang semua pernah encounter this, I promise.
Pinoy.
Pinohigut.
Pinokyo.
It's a food. Sarawak pun ada.
Eh, ada.
Tradisi kah? Tidak tradisi kah? Makan biasa?
Babi pinggang.
Bukan. Mau makan dia, mesti ada satu sup ni.
Minut.
Siapa pula?
Minut ni, Sambuya.
Betul lah.
Hah? Betul lah? Wih, betul. Wih!
Itu in Kadazan.
Oh.
Actually, Ambuya tu in Malay word.
Oh. Now we go to the last one. Is what they call as the Bandaya punya
language.
What is the word in Bandaya?
Ayat dia Hindu lah. Paling dekat dengan kita. Ayat dia Rawang.
Cinta.
Oh.
Bukan.
Dekat Selangor tu, Rawang.
Bukan.
Clue.
Clue. Manusia lah.
Ah, clue dah.
Manusia dekat dengan kita.
Roh Kudus.
Kekasih.
Bukan.
Aduh, salah.
Kekasih paling dekat kau apa? Ibu bapa ke?
Almost deh.
Uncle.
Bukan.
Adik beradik.
Ada kaitan.
Uncle.
Bukan. Ada kaitan.
Keluarga.
Yeah.
Mike Rawang.
Rawang.
Oh, biasa lah. Oh, this is my family in video.
Tiada Rawang body. Macam ini inilah rumah keluarga saya.
Oh. So now we are at the end of our video. So Japo,
okay.
What is your pesanan to everyone that is celebrating gawai masuk kamatan?
Pesanan aku, gaya bala ke nyambut hari gawai, kamat hari gawai, gayu guru, gerai nyamai.
What's your pesanan lah?
First of all, ketobian, tak ada tagazo do kamatan, kumado tompina isa biabi. Don't drink and drive. Be careful lah, jangan sampai gaduh-gaduh juga.
Okay, so Bobon, what is your wish?
My wish is selamat hari gawai daya, gawai sawa, harap hidup ingan sonang, dua mohon rami. Always stay safe, take care of others, and enjoy the celebration with friends and family.
Last but not least, my message to everyone watching. When you guys buy beer, make sure buy only the beer that is 100% due. So the question is, how do you want to know if your beer is duty paid or not? First, you need to check the description on the tin of the beer or the bottle of the beer. Make sure that there is the name of the manufacturer, which is Heineken, okay? Or the name of the company name, which is Heineken Malaysia Berhad. The second part is, if you want to know the beer is 100% duty paid, is make sure you need to check the address on the description. The address must be Kilang Beer, Sungai Weh, Petaling Jaya, Selangor. And also the third part, make sure you need to check the pack size. If the pack size is 120 ml on the tin, meaning to say your beer is duty paid. Last but not least, make sure you check on the barcode. It must start with the number 955. I repeat, 955. Why do you need to buy duty paid beer? It's because it is safe. Of course, you want to try the best beer and the most original beer in the world, which is Heineken. Alright, so are you guys ready for drinking?
Aus.
Aus. Alright, let's open. Sadom, sadom.
Pakai topi.
Pakai topi dah. Oh ya, yeah. Hey,
terus
mahal.
Wih. Apa mayu?
Apa minum.
Alright.
Cheers. Kalau Iban cheers mana?
Oha.
Oha.
Ayo guru gerai jemai.
Kek minum.
Betul-betul haus eh.
Terkejut lah.
Betul-betul haus eh.
Dadah.
Okay, mau cheers pak? Cheers
lah. Tuang lagi.
It was unexpected. Ready tuang again. Ready tuang for him. Okay, so now, cuma nak Kadazan cheers.
Aramaite!
Aramaite!
Sedap lah.
Sedap ini kan?
Sedap.
Beli meh, Heineken. 100% dibayar oleh custom.
Bukan custom yang bayar.
Custom yang bayar.
Duty paid apa?
Duty paid kena cukai.
Ah.
Cara bidayuh, cheers.
Bidayuh.
Bidayuh ya. Tara 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 tara
tara tara tara tara.
Mampu deh, berapa kali kita cheers sih. So that is all for our video today. I hope you guys enjoy watching our video. And don't forget that today's video is sponsored by Henneken. So don't forget to check out their website, Henneken Malaysia. And also don't forget to follow and also like Henneken Facebook page at Henneken Malaysia. And also Henneken, the official page. So thank you so much Henneken. You guys have the best year in the world. Last but not least, we want to wish everyone Selamat
Hari Gawai dan Keamanan.
Bila ada lagi sakit kau.